1,000 injuries of Fortunato I had borne as I best could, but when he ventured upon insult, I vowed revenge. You who so well know the nature of my soul will not suppose, however, that gave utterance to a threat. At length I would be avenged. This was a point definitely settled, but the very definitiveness with which it was resolved precluded the idea of risk. I must not only punish, but punish with impunity. A wrong is unrest when retribution overtakes its redresser. It is equally unrest when the avenger fails to make himself felt as such to him who has done the wrong. It must be understood that neither by word nor deed had I given Fortunato cause to doubt my goodwill. I continued to smile in his face, and he did not perceive that my smile now was at the thought of his immolation.
My dear Fortunato, you are luckily met. How remarkably well you are looking today.
Thank you.
I have received a pipe of what passes for Amontillado, and I have my doubts.
Amontillado? A pipe? Impossible. And in the middle of Carnival.
I have my doubts, and I was silly enough to pay the full Amontillado price without consulting you in the matter. You were not to be found, and I was fearful of losing a bargain.
Amontillado?
I have my doubts.
Amontillado?
And I must satisfy them.
Amontillado?
As you are engaged, I am on my way to Lutressi. If anyone has a critical turn, it is he. He will tell me.
Lutressi cannot tell Amontillado from Sherry.
And some fools will have it that his taste is a match for your own.
Let us go.
Sick on account of the dampness of the catacombs, I hastened to make an end of my labor. I forced the last stone into its position. I plastered it up. Against the new masonry, I re-erected the old rampart of bones. For half of a century, no mortal has disturbed them. In pace requiescat.